Ulan. Oldu ki. I think it's
next to the highway.
Yeah, it's direct access.
There is water under the land, I think the water table is high. Because of the plant.
This is what we have planned
for the
colorful.
5 hectares,
yeah? 5 hectares, yeah.
5 hectares.
55 hectares.
Okay. It's okay. Now we start, we need to start. You guys are already here.
Hi.
Welcome. This will be the team. They will stay and they will start to work.
Welcome here.
Mr. Prime Minister.
So this is the land.
This is the team.
Very good.
Adnan Bey is the hero who made the Turkistan airport in 11 months. Adnan Bey.
You were the one that had to stay there for 11 months, huh?
He will. He will.
The guy who's creating the Americans.
And he never saw the moon because it was the 24 hours light.
He's used to it. He's used to it.
The challenge is very big, as you all can understand. You are among them who have a big reputation of doing very challenging projects. Now we are here in your disposal. Everything will be set as you ask. Full support. You have the plan to have so many people working here. So welcome, and of course, the ambassador on your side and us on our side will be full support, right?
Exactly.
Thank you very much, Mr. Prime Minister. Yes, we as the YDA group was ordered by our president, Mr. Recep Tayyip Erdogan, last week during the visit of Honorable Prime Minister to Turkey. And we have been instructed that we have to finalize, we have to deliver the hospital in 3 months. There is a big bet on it. We know that it's a big challenge. And thanks for from the day first. We arrived yesterday. We feel the full support from the Albanian government side and from our ambassador also, His Excellency. And we will do our best. We came as a team and we will leave our team here. And we will start by working by tomorrow. Let's cross our fingers. Let's cross our fingers. We know that it's a big challenge, but we believe it. We will do it, and inshallah, before the elections, we will be honored to open the hospital by the honoring of the Mr. Prime Minister and our President Recep Tayyip Erdogan. I wish that it will be a very good investment for the Albanian healthcare infrastructure to improve and upgrade this. And we know the importance of the value of the Albania and the Turkish relationships. We are brothers. And we are very much honored to undertake such a challenging project as YDA Holding. And we promise to deliver on time. Thank you so much.
How much you foresee the investment to be overall, and how much people you foresee coming to work here?
Mr. Prime Minister, we expect that it would cost something like that, 60 to 70 million euros, and more than that. And we are expecting that for the peak time, we will rise up minimum 1,200 employees, workers to be working here, to deliver such a challenging project.
And you'll be, of course, 24 hours around the clock.
We will work. We will work by three shifts and 24 hours.
And how will be the combination between Turkish workforce and local?
Of course, we will utilize from the local manpower also. We expect that minimum 20 to 30%. To utilize the local manpower here, and we expect our Albanian brothers would support us for this. And all the products which we can find from Albania here, ready-made, we will prefer to buy it from here. The rest will come directly from Turkey.
We were discussing yesterday with Hussein, and he told me that in Turkey, in the big public works, the minimum, the average minimum of the workforce was $400 per month.
Yeah.
So this is important also for our people to hear that
the minimum,
you
range.
Know, yeah. in the
process.
In the project.
Yes.
So it's basically very near to what it is here in the public works. So it's important for people to hear that, because sometimes, you know, this is difficult to understand, and sometimes people make comparison with Germany and with France, but
yes, true, you are right, Mr. Prime Minister. In international standard of our Turkish projects, I am the Vice President of the Turkish Contractors Association also. This is the scala for the Turkish workers, and they're so happy to work with us.
Yeah, and the quality is top. So
yes,
this is important to.
They never complain to work hard. They never complain for the overtime, and the efficiency is much higher than the Europeans.
And it's also important to mention that the Turkish companies among the top three in the world.
We are the second.
We're the second now. In terms of the volume of the projects as seen all around them.
It's not only
the standards of Turkey, and it's international standards.
I also learned the minimum wage in Turkey.
Mm-hmm.
Overall is 340, right?
True.
So we made it 300 this year. Of course, there is still a gap, but we had it 7 years ago, was 200 and something. So, you know, it's not enough for sure, but it's an improvement.
As long as they match with our pricing scala and our efficiency, we are very much happy to work with our Albanian local brothers, local laborership here.
Yeah, so this will be a challenge to open a fast call and to talk to the small companies around and the small contractors to see what they can offer. But I'm very confident that you'll make it.
Inshallah.
It's not my promise, sir. I didn't promise it.
I don't.
I want to make sure that the people hear it. It's the promise of president. And if the promise will not be kept, it's him. It's not me. Because people should not forget that. We'll do all the best to not let you call back to the ambassador or to him and say, we lost a day of work because of Albanian bureaucracy, because of Albanian whatever. So we'll be 24 hours around the clock with you, the minister, the team, the project manager from our side will be put in place to work with him just to respond to every request. So you don't need to go in any office, anywhere. Will be behind you.
Thank you.
All the time.
This is our expectation. Also, we would like just to work here on site.
Great.